you were the monster?
No. And it's not Iago. It's Federal Agent Schmidlap from the U.S. Department of Defense. Three weeks ago, one of our experimental exoskeletons designed to increase the strength of the infantrymen of the future was stolen from one of our research labs. I traced it to this town and went undercover in hopes of ferreting it out. Go ahead, guys.
Wait, you were the monster in the lab?
No, not me. It was Burgermeister.
But that's impossible. He was with Scooby and me when we were chasing the Franken-creep.
But that's because someone else was dressed like the Franken-creep at the time. This is one mystery that doesn't have a culprit. It has a conspiracy.
Right. And that's why they hypnotized you, Velma.
Hypnotized? Who hypnotized you and why?
And how did Scooby and I become brave, not to mention full? Like, that was the weirdest feeling in the world.
Wait. Most importantly, how on earth did I end up in an inflatable suit? Okay, maybe not most importantly, but I'd sure like to know. Spill!
First of all, I didn't solve this mystery. Fred had it figured out right away.
I did. Could you explain how I did?
You said it when the mystery machine exploded. This time it's personal. And it was. A personal attack on the Scooby Gang.
Cuthbert Crawley?
Why would your family lawyer want to destroy us?
He's not my family lawyer. I'd never seen him before. He's really Cuthbert Crawls, the partner of Cosgood Creeps.
They were those creepy attorneys that haunted the Beauregard Sanders mansion as the Green Ghosts.
What kind of ghost would travel hundreds of miles to haunt a lawyer's office anyway? He wasn't there to scare us off. He was there to draw us in. Everyone knows we can't resist a mystery. The so-called Baron's Curse was supposed to take away the things we cared about most. The first victim, the mystery machine. The next victim was Daphne, who started puffing up thanks to her shellfish allergy. She had no way of knowing that she was also slipping into its built-in inflatable suit. And next up were Scooby and Shaggy, whose suits were also rigged, but with acupuncture needles concealed carefully inside. The pressure points not only suppressed hunger, they also created a false sense of courage, giving them the confidence to chase after the monster. As for me, I was hypnotized by Mrs. Vanders into believing I could recreate my uncle's experiment. Which I did. At least, enough to create a diversion. A diversion for one of the conspirators, dressed as the Franken-creep to switch places with the lifeless dummy.
They sure went to a lot of trouble to scare us off. But what was the treasure they were trying to scare us off from?
This time, it wasn't about money. It was about us.
But why? Who would do such a thing? We don't even know these people.
Don't be so sure.
Seal Magnus?
Yes, the shipping magnate who masqueraded as Redbeard's ghost. And as for our mysterious gypsy?
Lila?
Yes, aspiring pop singer Lila, who was one of Mamba Wamba's zombies.
That means this is no housekeeper.
Mama Mione?
Mama Mione? You were like a criminal gang leader pretending to be old Iron Face.
Jeepers, of course. I should have recognized that mask.
I guess even criminals recycle. You get it? Recycle.
Who would have thought there'd be a conspiracy of people determined to destroy us?
Are you kidding? Everyone you've ever busted wants revenge. We were turning people away in droves.
We fiended each other on the Scooby Gang Revenge social networking page. You wouldn't believe how many yikes it gets on a daily basis.
It took us months, but once we found out about Dinkley's family, we pooled our resources and bought the castle.
Then we slowly insinuated ourselves into the town with our chosen identities.
Imagine our joy when we discovered the natural gas pockets under the estate. The castle became one enormous death trap.
We would have gotten a revenge on you meddling kids.
If it weren't for you meddling kids.